New design for Starship V3. After a long period of anticipation, SpaceX has finally revealed a key aspect of the development of the next generation Starship: the newly developed nose cone. Designed to improve aerodynamic efficiency and tailored to complement Starship's impressive height of 150 meters, the new nose cone represents more than just an aesthetic upgrade. It is designed to optimize performance for future missions to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. What innovations can we expect from Starship V3? Let's dive into it in today's episode of NR Studio. Among the many improvements introduced with Starship V3, the craft's newly designed nose cone stands out as being quite remarkable, not to mention one of the most challenging components to manufacture. While the substantial dimensions of a spacecraft always draw attention, the nose cone sets itself apart for reasons beyond mere aesthetic appeal. The nose cone serves a critical function, not only by navigating the atmosphere and minimizing drag during flight, but also by withstanding the extreme heat and pressures of its mission. As a result, the nose cone is considered one of the most challenging components to manufacture, holding a position as important and complex as the powerful Raptor engines. Recently, images of Starship 39's nose cone have emerged, offering a glimpse inside the Star Factory before the peak of assembly. The most striking aspect that immediately catches the eye is the incredible smoothness and shine of the surface. It's nearly perfect. The prominent welds, irregular seams, and inconsistent finishes that characterize previous iterations are all but gone. This significant advancement can be attributed to SpaceX's innovative robotic laser welding technique. Laser welding has elevated production quality to a level that is not only cleaner and more precise, but also far more consistent. The improvements observed in the nose cone of Starship 39 strongly suggest that SpaceX is entering the early stages of Starship V3 production. These modifications go beyond incremental improvements. They indicate a comprehensive reimagining of the nose cone for future development. Let's explore in more detail the distinctive features that make this new nose cone so remarkable. Its composition remains unchanged, consisting of 30L stainless steel, which is renowned for its exceptional strength and durability. However, there has been a significant evolution in construction techniques. Rather than using the method of stacking and welding short horizontal steel rings, SpaceX has switched to using vertically aligned longitudinal steel plates. It appears that these 12 vertical panels have been fused together to form the structural integrity of the nose cone. This technique results in a much smoother and more polished surface, minimizing the amount of welding and thus reducing potential failure points. But what motivated SpaceX to switch to vertically aligned panels? The reasoning is rooted in insights gained from previous designs, as well as the requirements of the upcoming Starship V3 mission. From an engineering and physics standpoint, the construction of a nose cone that utilizes horizontally stacked rings requires the incorporation of numerous circumferential welds. These circumferential welds present a potential weak point due to the extreme aerodynamic stresses experienced by the nose cone during launch and reentry. Compression, shear, and bending forces exhibit an uneven distribution across the surface, making these welds highly susceptible to cracking or structural failure. Additionally, upon reaching orbital speeds of approximately 17,600 miles per hour, equivalent to nearly 28,300 kilometers per h, the Starship nose cone experiences temperatures that can soar as high as 2,500 degrees Fahrenheit. Compact horizontal rings create an irregular distribution of heat, especially at the welds, increasing the risk of thermal distortion or structural failure. By switching to vertical panels, SpaceX effectively addresses both of these issues simultaneously. The vertical welds are aligned parallel to the airflow during ascent, effectively reducing aerodynamic drag, minimizing turbulence, and improving overall flight efficiency. Because of the inherent ductility derived from its tensile structure, 30L stainless steel provides greater safety and exceptional durability to the new design. This promotes increased reusability and minimizes maintenance intervals after each flight. SpaceX's goals for Starship are nothing short of extraordinary. At the 31st Annual Barron's Investment Conference last year, SpaceX COO Gwynn Shotwell expressed his anticipation that we could potentially see a Starship launch within the next 4 years. With such an accelerated launch cadence, even small structural vulnerabilities can quickly escalate into significant challenges. Ensuring the reliability and safety of critical components, such as the nose cone, is paramount. Furthermore, the Starship version 3 nose cone is anticipated to be 1.2 meters taller than its predecessor. Adhering to the previous horizontal ring design would result in an increased number of rings and consequently a greater number of welds. Each additional weld introduces an additional potential failure point. If SpaceX envisions Starship to survive multiple flights while safely transporting individuals and cargo to the Moon, Mars, and beyond, the new and improved nose cone design represents more than just an aesthetic upgrade. It's a transformation that is both strategically significant and important. With the impressive new nose cone adorning Ship 39, SpaceX is signaling that Starship version 3 is poised to not only be bigger, but also demonstrate increased power, intelligence, and readiness for the coming era of space exploration. After examining the nose cones of Starship versions 1 and 2, it's clear that version 3 is charting a slightly different path. The version 2 nose cone design remains consistent with version 1. It retains the fundamental elliptical cone configuration, featuring a slightly rounded apex in place of a protruding point. This design facilitates reduced drag during ascent and promotes more uniform heat distribution during reentry. However, SpaceX has implemented a subtle but significant modification in version 2. They appear to have reduced the cone angle by about 15 to 20 degrees. This modification gives the nose a slightly sleeker, more tapered appearance relative to version 1. With the release of version 3, Musk appears ready to stretch the design parameters even further, literally. As he has said, if the version 3 nose cone reaches its anticipated length of 15 to 16 meters, its optimal ratio, defined as the proportion of length to diameter, will increase significantly. This modification will improve the perception of the nose, making it sleeker and more elongated than version 2. A sleeker nose cone will significantly reduce aerodynamic drag during ascent, a consideration that becomes even more important given version 3's expanded dimensions and increased payload capacity. Despite the design changes, significant similarities remain between Starship versions 1, 2, and 3. The forward flaps remain attached to the nose cone. However, their position, design, and integration have evolved with each subsequent iteration. In version 2, the forward flaps are repositioned toward the leeward side, departing from the symmetrical placement observed in version 1. This modification effectively reduces thermal loads during reentry, thereby keeping the flaps from burning up or disintegrating under extreme temperatures, a challenge that was evident during Starship's fourth flight. Given SpaceX's established design patterns, it is likely that the forward flaps on version 3 will remain positioned on the nose cone. They will likely be larger to accommodate the vehicle's increased dimensions. The flaps will retain their inclination toward the leeward side. However, SpaceX could improve their design or refine their control mechanisms. Up to this point, our attention has been primarily focused on the external architecture. However, let's shift our focus to the internal components of the version 3 nose cone. Located within the nose cone of every Starship iteration are vital systems that are integral to its operational efficacy during flight. First, we encounter the header tank, a compact auxiliary fuel reservoir strategically positioned just below the apex of the truncated nose cone. This tank fulfills a vital function by supplying fuel to the Raptor engines during the critical final landing burn. During Starship's epic flip maneuver as it transitions from a horizontal descent to a vertical landing, the reliability of the main tank is reduced by the fuel spilling inside it. The elevated header tank, which is independently pressurized, ensures a consistent and steady fuel supply at critical moments. In version 3, the header tanks are expected to be significantly enlarged, increasing their capacity to around 15-20 cubic meters each, as opposed to the 10-15 cubic meters seen in previous versions. This will be important in facilitating higher landing weights, longer missions, and increased payload capacity. Next, we find the avionics and sensor systems positioned near the middle or bottom of the nose cone, adjacent to its junction with the payload bay. Numerous sensors, including temperature, pressure, and acceleration, have been deployed to closely monitor conditions inside the header tanks and throughout the vehicle. This complex network of electronic circuit boards, communications equipment, and flight computers performs critical functions, including sending data to mission control and managing the operation of the four flaps during reentry. The avionics suite in version 3 is set to undergo substantial upgrades. It will have to accommodate the increased payload capacity, accelerate re-entry speeds, and handle more complex flight profiles. Similarly, improvements will be made to the heat shield tiles surrounding the nose cone to improve insulation efficiency, thereby protecting the fragile electronics from the intense heat generated during re-entry. In short, the Starship version 3 nose cone goes beyond aesthetic enhancements. It represents a substantial advancement in aerodynamic efficiency and internal engineering. From sleek new aerodynamic designs to sophisticated internal systems, each modification has been carefully crafted to enhance Starship's capabilities for faster flights, increased payload capacity, and greater frequency of missions to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. SpaceX is developing a spacecraft designed not just for individual flights, but for a broad set of missions, with the innovative nose cone serving as a critical component of this bold vision. In addition to its nose cone, Starship version 3 offers a number of significant enhancements that push the boundaries of its performance and reusability. A key enhancement is the incorporation of the Raptor 3 engines. Each Raptor 3 is expected to produce approximately 280 tons of thrust, far surpassing the power of its predecessors. In addition to its robust power, the Raptor 3 offers improved fuel efficiency, increased specific impulse, and superior endurance. These improvements are critical to achieving faster turnaround times between flights, a fundamental goal of SpaceX's goal of making space travel more common and economically viable. A recent photo has surfaced of what appears to be a Raptor 3 vacuum engine on the move in McGregor, Texas. The engine features a much wider nozzle, carefully designed for optimal performance in a vacuum. The design embodies a more refined and efficient approach. Importantly, the engine appears to be free of the external heat shields, welds, and bolts that characterized previous iterations. These modifications not only simplify the manufacturing process, but also improve reliability and performance. Another significant improvement in Starship V3 is the heat shield system. SpaceX has moved beyond the conventional silica and alumina tiles used in previous prototypes. They are instead investigating advanced ceramics such as silicon carbide and zirconium diboride, which are capable of withstanding extreme temperatures that reach 2,000 degrees Celsius, equivalent to more than 3,600 degrees Fahrenheit. These materials provide exceptional resistance to the extreme thermal and mechanical forces experienced during re-entry. Additionally, the dimensions of the heat shield tiles have been expanded, transitioning from 10 by 10 centimeters to approximately 15 by 15 centimeters. The reduction in the number of tiles results in fewer seams, further reducing the likelihood of tiles coming loose during flight. Additionally, this speeds up the assembly process, which is a significant advantage for a vehicle intended for rapid reusability. The series of improvements, from the engines to the heat shield, illustrate that Starship V3 represents not just an evolution, but a significant step forward toward making space travel consistent and reliable. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one.